The Tar Heels of North Carolina against the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers University. You'll see all the action live tonight on the Raycom Sports Network.
Raycom Sports presents Basketball. Today's game is being brought to you by Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. By Hardee's, best eaten all around. By Honda, we make it simple. And by Rosen, the more you know about us, the more you can see.
Big Apple, as Dean Smith's top-ranked North Carolina Tar Heels take their act on the road for the first time in this 1981-82 basketball campaign, undefeated against Tom Young's Scarlet Knights of Rutgers University, a team that has won five and lost only one, and count among their five victories, upset wins over UCLA and St. John's, as the Scarlet Knights come into this game with a four-game winning streak. Good evening, everybody. Marty Brenneman along with Bones McKinney as the North Carolina Tar Heels look to win their fifth consecutive game of the season tonight, and Bones keep their number one ranking in both polls intact.
Well, I think that a lot of people think this is going to be a pushover against Rutgers, but they're far from being right. Rutgers has the ability, Marty, to do a good job on North Carolina as long as they can set their own tempo. And as we heard from Dong Myung, if they're able to shoot 50 or 60%.
John Condon.
Center number 41, Sam Perkins. And at the dogs, number 21, Jimmy Black. And number 44, Matt Doherty. And the coach of the Tar Heels, Dean Smith. At the chorus, number 34, Chris Lieberline. Number 35, Clarence Tillman. At center, number 32, Roy Henson. Guards, number 20, Kevin Black. And number 24, Brian Ellaby. And the coach of Rutgers, Tom Young. The officials, Tom Adams, John Clockerty, and Bruce Shapiro.
Three officials tonight, Tom Adams and Bruce Shapiro from the Eastern Eight and John Clockerty from the Atlantic Coast Conference. We've got a trio. It'll be Roy Henson jumping center for Rutgers, Sam Perkins doing the honors for Carolina, and the Tar Heels will have a go at it right out of the chute. Jimmy Black, of course, the point guard for the Tar Heels, along with Sam Perkins, Matt Doherty, Chris Brust, and James Worthy. And right away, the Rutgers Scarlet Knights going to his own defense. Tom Young told us it is imperative that his club defensively take the Carolina fast breakaway if they have hopes of staying in this ball game. Worthy, the top scorer on the Tar Heel team, gets it inside the perfect.
He's about as clever like that, Marty, with that kind of shot as anybody can possibly be. Moves it up real well, real soft.
Carolina having no trouble at all. Their first time down the floor against the Rutgers defense, and almost turning it over is Ellerby. Loose ball picked up by Kevin Black. Now Tillman has his shot deflected. A good defensive play, Bones, by Jimmy Black.
Jimmy Black moved in behind him, flipped the ball, and it was caught in the air. And Tillman was called for walking with the ball. You're going to see the situation right here. You saw Black moving behind Tillman, and he did pick the ball up before he hit the floor.
Meanwhile, Jimmy Black gets a word from Coach Dean Smith and now brings it front court. Carolina leading 2-0. We are a minute gone into the second game of this Saturday night Madison Square Garden doubleheader.
And Rutgers is in a 1-3-1 zone, packing it in the middle, trying to keep it out of there.
Jimmy Black with a hand in his face from Chris Niederlein goes cross court to Daugherty. Perkins, who has the only field goal, as Carolina was able to penetrate the Rutgers zone for an easy basket by Sam Perkins, the first time down the floor.
They're going to pack it in there, Marty, so deep it's almost to the foul line to keep it from going in the middle.
Daugherty moving by Tillman, but now checked and has to give it back up to Sam Perkins. So Rutgers doing a good job with that zone defense as they move from side to side with the flow of the basketball.
They've got to move the ball around and flip it from one side. Now Perkins is going to have to get the ball over to Jimmy Black if he can get that good shot.
Jimmy Black, the pass intended for, picked up by Niederlein. Now Brian Ellerby, the freshman, getting a chance to start in the absence of Rich Brunson. Rutgers trying to tie it up as they go up top. Ellerby takes a pass, misses a layup. He tries a reverse, and a foul is going to be called inside against James Werther.
Well, they had too many opportunities on that, Marty. They were going to get one of them after a few minutes, and Ellerby, of all people, was the smallest man. We see the situation there. Henson went in. Ellerby put it back up. Ellerby goes after it again. As you see him put it on the floor, he's going to the other side and put it up again. And this time, James Worthy is going to put the arm on him, and he did.
Actually, Bones, it looked like the pass was intended for Henson. It was overthrown, and Ellerby happened to be there.
That's exactly right.
So Brian Ellerby, a freshman out of Bowie, Maryland, averaging 2.5 points a game, and he comes up with the first Rutgers point of the night. It's a 2-1 ball game with 18 minutes and a second to go in the first half. Lockup. Michael Jordan bouncing up off the Tar Heel bench. He's going to come out at the next opportunity as Black gets some backcourt pressure from Brian Ellerby. Ellerby starting with Kevin Black, Clarence Tillman, Roy Henson, and Chris Niederlein. The starting lineup for Tom Young Scarlet Knights, Jimmy Black from downtown. The long rebound is owned by the Rutgers ball club.
Rutgers needs to keep cutting through there. Ellerby did a smart thing by pulling off to the side.
Russ coming out high to pick up Ellerby. Contact made. Perkins, a plastic man, deflects the ball, but is picked up by Ellerby, and Rutgers will start their offense again. 2-2 the score, 17-20 to go in the first half.
North Carolina man for man, a real good man for man.
On the move is Kevin Black, rebounded by Chris Bruss. Carolina with quite a following up here in the Garden tonight. That pass intended for Worthy, and a foul called on Roy Henson, his first, and the first team foul against Rutgers.
Henson came right over the top. You see Jordan's in there now, and Brust is out. Brust played well for the 3 minutes that he was in the ballgame.
So each club has been charged with a team foul. Carolina will inbounds as Jimmy Black's talking to his ball club, and Matt Daugherty will act as a Carolina trigger man. Worthy, the third-ranking scorer in the Atlantic Coast Conference and the top scorer in the Carolina club with an average of 18.5. Tar Heels have three players averaging in double figures. Here's Black into the land of the Giants. Off to Perkins, who looks for help, finds it in Jimmy Black. He goes inside to Perkins. Can he get it? No, and a whistle and a traveling violation call against Sam Perkins.
Might have been a little slip of the foot there, Marty. Might have been a little bit, not much. We'll see it here. You're going to see Black try to hit Perkins in the middle. You see him get the ball, but you cannot see the walk, but he did walk.
Michael Jordan, of course, is in the lineup for Carolina. Tar Heels with four players in double figures. Worthy, Jordan, Perkins, and Daugherty. That's Clarence Tillman, the transfer from the University of Kentucky in his second year at Rutgers, and that's Chris Niederlein. And Rutgers takes a 4-2 lead.
That's the way it's going, what it's going to take for both clubs. It's going to take some good outside shooting. North Carolina's going to have to hit for the outside. They're all the way back to the foul line on their defense.
This game starting out much in the same vein as game one between Princeton and Ohio State. Princeton, of course, a very deliberate, plotting type of club, something that Ohio State had to contend with, and Carolina obviously is faced with the same thing here from Rutgers.
They're going to have to hit from the outside, Marty, and draw them outside. Niederlein was called for the foul, and North Carolina will take the ball out of bounds.
Carolina staring at a two-point deficit with 16-18 to go in the first half from Madison Square Garden. Michael Jordan, Jimmy Black, freshman to senior. Up top to Worthy.
I knew they'd go to it in a second because they're going to have to lob that ball a lot to Perkins and also to Worthy.
Blocking foul called against Jim Black as he goes down at midcourt. Bill Guthridge a little bit upset with the official call, momentarily restrained by Coach Dean Smith, and Black is called for the personal foul. As we take a look at
you're going to see the situation right here. This is the pass that was just passed into Perkins, a lob pass to Worthy, a lob pass, and it was beautiful.
Two team fouls in the Tar Heels. First on Jimmy Black, a 4-4 tie. Kevin Black, a junior from Washington, D.C., brings it front court. Tom Young calls him the most consistent player on the Rutgers team.
North Carolina's going into a little trap job.
Ellerby handles the basketball against a defensive Black. Now to Nieberlein, and he took one step too many. And turns the ball back over to North Carolina. Oh, we've got a break in the action here at Madison Square Garden. 15:46 to go in the first half. Carolina and Rutgers are tied up at 4-4, and right now we'll pause for this timeout.
The top, Marty, this freshman, number 24, Ellerby, is a heck of a basketball player and as strong as anybody could possibly be that playing the point guard.
Well, he's built like a tailback, I'll tell you that. Daugherty off to Michael Jordan. Talked about this young man's fine play, and this is freshman year for the Tar Heels. Jimmy Black tried to penetrate. The ball deflected, and Jordan climbs the ladder to pick off the errant pass. They go to Worthy for the turnaround. And the rebound with position inside by Clarence Tillman. Up ahead it goes to Nieberlein, checked by Daugherty, and they'll bring it back outside to the backliners Kevin Black and Brian Ellerby. Inside to Hinson, he decks Daugherty, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
That was a beautiful move by Daugherty. He was not guarding Tillman, but he went over to help out, and when he did, he just received the charging foul.
Bones, Matt Daugherty will take a charge, won't he?
You know, I've seen recently where they're keeping that in stats now. How many charges have you taken?
It's an excellent idea because that's an intangible that up until now has never shown up in statistical data that really can determine the great value of a basketball player, certainly in the case of a Matt Daugherty. That's James Worthy at the other end.
That was a good move. Jordan was responsible for it. And he'll sky and then make somebody take him and drop off to Perkins and Worthy.
Carolina has its second lead. They were up 2-0. They now lead 6-4. Worthy has two hoops. They work the ball low in the quick hands of Daugherty. Knocks it OB. The ball intended for Roy Hinson.
Matt Daugherty's mother and daddy are sitting behind us, and I think he's putting a little extra effort in this ball game.
Ellerby inbounds deep. It goes to Kevin Black.
They'll give him a whooping when he gets home, but don't.
Daugherty and Jordan all over Clarence Tillman. He's a high scorer on Rutgers' club, averaging 15 points a game. Carolina will like to be able to shut him off tonight. He handles the ball right now and gives it back to Ellerby. Nieberlein back out front. Rutgers trying to score another big upset after earlier beating UCLA. They would love to hand Carolina its first loss of the season and Tillman's first bomb.
North Carolina's defense move is quick that time.
Once again, Rutgers drops conveniently and comfortably back into the zone defense.
The man on the baseline playing the 1-3-1 is almost in the stands.
Under 14 minutes to go in the first half. Daugherty from the baseline. Matt Daugherty with his first field goal.
North Carolina will come along picking them apart. They're going to have to change the zone a little bit from a 1-3-1. May go to a 2-1-2 or a 2-3.
Carolina again leads by a field goal at 8-6. Tillman stalked by Daugherty, plays to Hinson. Underneath it goes to the little guy, and Ellerby uses his muscle to get it up and in.
That's right, Marty. Muscle was the word, not ability to jump.
4 points for Brian Ellerby, filling in for Rich Brunson, and so far doing a fine, fine job as that field goal gets Rutgers a tie at 8.
They're going to have to be patient tonight, as most coaches will say, against a zone like that, because there's no place to go inside with it. You've got to throw a lob pass most of the time.
Well, they're checking Daugherty with a little bit more vengeance now after he hit that baseline jumper the last time down the floor. Black whips it inside to Worthy, who tries to do his magic. It went in, came out, and Nieberlein is right there to pick it off.
Just see him. He faked a pass in the air, came down, drove with it, and just a tough break cost him the basket.
These two clubs over the many, many years have played but 4 times. Carolina has won 3 of the 4, including a 71-64 victory in Charlotte last year, a game that Well, it was really close. Rutgers trailed by only three with a couple of minutes to go. Carolina ended up winning it by seven. Black comes tight on Ellerby. Kevin Black checked by the freshman Jordan, and there's Tillman. They cannot leave him open from that range. The ball had a shot, but it rolls off, and a foul is called inside.
Darty got him on the wrist as he started to go up and release the ball. He almost made the basket anyway.
Michael Jordan is charged with a personal foul, his first.
Personal foul, and the Tar Heels have three team fouls.
Well, both teams now with three team fouls, and that'll be a two-shot situation for Tillman as Jordan got him in the act of shooting. Chris Remley, a freshman from Warren, New Jersey, 6'9", a 200-pounder, is going to become the first Rutgers substitution in for Chris Niederlein. Interesting to note on the Rutgers note sheet, they mentioned the fact Carolina is 3-0 against Rutgers.
First game was played when?
Well, actually, Rutgers has a win.
I know it.
Unless you consider 1921 the dark ages, when Rutgers won 25-22.
Well, they just played a quarter, huh?
By today's standards, that would be about right.
Not right. That's about how much time they went after shooting.
Tillman trying to split the two-shot foul and get his club a one-point lead. Rutgers 9, North Carolina 8. Jimmy Black brings it front court for the men in the blue and white. As they again look at that Rutgers zone defense, 12 minutes, 13, 12, 11 seconds to go in the half.
They're giving them anything they want from 15 feet, but they're keeping a hand up at 15 feet.
Carolina typically has been a good shooting team again this season, hitting better than 56% of their shots from the floor en route to a 75-point-per-game average, and they've been an outstanding defensive club, giving up 59.5 points a game, and that, of course, was helped immeasurably by the 39 that they checked South Florida on last Saturday night at Carmichael Auditorium. Michael Jordan, bingo.
They can shoot that ball from out there and will do it. But they certainly have to shoot from out there because there's no room on the inside unless they lob it.
He's hitting 15.5 points per game on 67% accuracy. And there's Jimmy Black with a Tar Heel rebound. Black has Perkins breaking, but he wants to go coast to coast. Threw up a bad shot. Tillman rebounds, and the Scarlet Knights quickly bring it the other way.
I'll bet you Tom Young doesn't want to get in a running game.
10-9, Carolina up by a point. They work it downstairs for the turnaround by Hinson. Rebounded by Worthy. He was sandwiched in between two players, Chris Remley and Brian Ellerby, and a Rutgers foul. But that will be coming up after the timeout with a score, Tar Heels 10, Scarlet Knights 9. We'll pause for these messages on the Raycom Sports Network. It appears that Rutgers has been able to deliver to dictate the pace of the game.
They sure have. They only tried to run with them a couple of times. That's not a good policy, I don't believe, for Rutgers in this situation. But I can't believe his own defense is packed that deep in there.
No changes in the Carolina lineup. There's Jordan. This time he comes up short. And Chris Remley controls for Rutgers. Carolina's made one substitution, so too is Tom Young. Kevin Black to Chris Remley. He's a man who came off the bench just a moment ago. They are trying, consistently trying, to get that ball inside. Hinson failed to put enough on it to roul it over the iron, but he did pick up a foul as charged against James Worthy. That's going to be his second.
That's one thing that North Carolina can ill afford. That's to lose a man like Perkins or Worthy because they are so dependable when he comes down the wire.
Foul number two on James Worthy, and right back into the Rutgers lineup comes Chris Niederlein, the junior from Sykesville, Maryland, replacing Clarence Tillman. Henson, the captain of the Rutgers team, puts it up and in. Carolina 5 of 9 from the field, Rutgers 3 out of 7 thus far, and Rutgers has out-rebounded Carolina 5-3.
North Carolina hasn't been to the foul line, and Rutgers has been there with 5 free throws out of about 6 chances.
The Rutgers leads again by the score this time of 11-10. Perkins backing, plays to Jordan. He gives it to the breaking Perkins and stripped of the ball by Chris Niederlein. Outstanding defensive play.
A beautiful pass and yet a beautiful block.
Sam Perkins will not have that occur to him too many times over the course of a basketball season. Niederlein with an out-of-sight defensive play. Now they'd like to score. Ellerby has it rejected by Perkins. Remley with a follow. The rebound to Sam Perkins.
They're trying to post Black in there. Ellerby is.
Carolina looking to get the lead back. Showing the patience that Tom Young talked to Bones and I about before the telecast tonight. Worthy gets open inside for the turnaround. That's deflected and pulled down by Roy Hinson.
And North Carolina's not used to this. One block by for Worthy and one block by Perkins. This is not what they're looking for.
Well, I'll tell you, Rutgers playing some outstanding defense right now. Leading by a point with 9 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the first half. Worthy or Jordan trying to avoid a foul and just was able to do so. Nieberlein flies high. Brimley goes low to Hinson. He traveled. They didn't call it. Controlled inside, deflected away. Here comes Daugherty in Carolina.
More block shots than I've seen in a long time, Marty.
Good pass by Worthy. Daugherty can't get it to go down, and a foul is called inside on Chris Remley or Nieberlein. Let's see how the officials go with it. Tillman's going to come back for Rutgers. Matt Daugherty gets a blow. Jeff Barlow comes into the game for North Carolina.
Hinson goes out. He's given as much rest as he can with as few substitutes as he can. Coach Tom Young.
Rutgers in trouble now, Bones. Hinson's just been called for his third personal foul. Jordan on the move, gets by Tillman. I'll tell you one thing, Rutgers certainly getting up on the boards with North Carolina.
And Michael Jordan making a very foolish backcourt foul.
Second foul against Jordan, team foul number 5 against Carolina, and Daugherty's time on the bench turns out to be very brief. He's right back in and replaces Mike Jordan.
The floor. We'll see if they're trapped when they do. Yes, they're trapping.
Daugherty and Barlow trapping there, trying to force a turnover against Kevin Black, but Rutgers has no problem getting the ball over the timeline and into the front court. They go up top to Nieberlein. His shot deflected. Daugherty kicks it out to Black.
Boy, it's rough under that basket. I mean rough.
Excellent pass inside. Perkins started skyward, and he's called for traveling.
I think the pass was intended for Worthy, and Perkins went through there and picked the pass up, ran with the ball.
Dean Smith appealing to the officials, obviously not liking that call a little bit. A very low-scoring first half that has Rutgers leading 11-10, 8 minutes and 12 seconds to go. Jimmy Black matched up against Ellerby. Now Kevin Black against Daugherty. Perkins has Tillman. Remley will shoot over the leaping Worthy, and he gets it.
Good shooter. Good shooter.
That's the biggest lead for Rutgers. 3 points at 13-10.
Just check where Ellerby is now. He isn't any closer than the foul line. He's on the foul line. He darts out occasionally.
Carolina goes to its strength inside. James Worthy with his third field goal. Carolina cuts a deficit to 1 point. Ellerby about to be picked up by Black and now hurries up. Scattered situation. And they fail to take advantage of it, but Worthy lost it over the end line. Dean Smith wanted a foul call there on a pushing violation against Rutgers, but the officials didn't see it that way. With 7 minutes and 26 seconds remaining in the first half here in the Garden in New York, the score Rutgers 13 and North Carolina 12. A one-point game as we pause for this timeout. Pretty good.
They've been as good as they want to be tonight, right. With that defense, good gracious.
Clarence Tillman turns around and puts it up. The ball trickles off the hands of Jeff Barlow, but waiting to play it is Matt Daugherty. Carolina with a field goal can jump out in front. 13-12 Rutgers. Carolina with three players in their lineup right now who played high school basketball in this area. Jimmy Black, of course, from Cardinal Hayes in the Bronx. Chris Bruss from Babylon High School in Babylon, New York. And Matt Daugherty, who knocks that one in from Holy Trinity High School. Daugherty with his second field goal.
Matt's putting on a show for the home folks.
Of course, Sam Perkins grew up in Brooklyn. As we pointed out, four players on this club play their high school basketball in and around this area. 1 point up, Carolina over Rutgers.
Black really covers up for somebody that makes a mistake.
Worthy deflected it out of bounds, trying to get the official to go the other way with it, but Rutgers will keep it. John Battle, a freshman from Washington, D.C., on for Brian Ellerby. Mike Jordan comes back for Carolina as he checks in for James Worthy.
Dean's giving them a little rest because Rutgers has been given some rest. He just took Tom Young, took out one, put in another, took out another, put in another. He's doing a pretty good job with just six men.
Ball goes inbounds to Battle. He'll bring it outside as he now takes a turn at running the ball club with Brian Ellerby getting a breather on the bench. Good move by Nieberlein. Knocked away by Doherty. Foot races on. Thrust up ahead to Black. But a whistle at center court will eliminate that basket, and a foul is going to be charged on Nieberlein.
And that is one of the things that they should let go on and then call the foul, let the basket go, because, heck, that's the thing to do.
And Rutgers has 16 fouls.
16 fouls have been charged against Rutgers. Brust, the man who was a recipient of the foul.
It was a block from the rear. I think he hit him too high. You can't do that in football.
Well, a good defensive play because Jimmy Black had an uncontested layup at the other end. Jordan gets close, tried to kick it off inside, and another whistle, and still another foul, and Tom Young throws his hand skyward in obvious disgust over the call against his club.
Behind the basket now, Rutgers fans are behind the Carolina basket, and they're giving a little hee-haw out there, throwing coats up in the air, but it didn't make any difference to Mike Jordan.
His third point, and now Jimmy Braddock comes in for the first time as you look at Tom Young. Jimmy Braddock was an iffy situation, as we mentioned at the top of the show, because of an ankle injury that he suffered in practice on Wednesday. But he is, in fact, in the lineup right now replacing Jimmy Black.
And didn't practice yesterday, did he?
Sure did not. Jordan gets them both. Carolina pushes its lead to three as Braddock and Perkins defend the backpedaling John Battle. Remley, Nieberlein. They'll set up.
North Carolina pressing when they can, double-teaming when they can, but still sticking that man-for-man defense.
Rutgers trying to extend its winning streak to five in a row, and with shooters like Chris Remley.
He's a good shooter. He's got a good touch, and I think he's hit about two in a row now. I believe I'd put some hands on him.
They are hanging right in there. 16-15, Carolina by a point. Mike Jordan, Jim Braddock, excellent long-range shooter. They check him, though, with their hands held up in that zone defense. Now Jordan. Matt Doherty all by himself. And now Braddock had a pick from Bruss, but elects to dribble away from the end line and give up the shot.
They want to get James Worthy in there. He's on the sidelines, and the only way to do that is stop the play.
There's a turnover. Clarence Tillman up ahead to Battle. He will put up the running one-hander.
Oh, man, he didn't even get iron that time. North Carolina's going to have their hands full until they start lobbing that ball in to Perkins and to the other tall people that are in there, or taking a good outside shot.
There's Perkins turning with that jump hook. The short, Nieberlein really scrapping inside to get the rebound.
Young man's played a good ball game, Nieberlein has.
Had a brother who also played with Rutgers and graduated last spring. That's Chris with the ball now and plays to Tillman. Tillman will jump it. Carolina will rebound it. Chris Bruss doing a good job, Bones.
Oh, he's doing a real good job. Going to the boards as well as anybody for North Carolina. North Carolina's having to play a little bit harder, I believe, than they came prepared to play. It's tough to get up for somebody sometimes.
Michael Jordan plays it back out to Braddock. Inside to Bruss. Loose ball picked up by Perkins.
You got to have some of those, Marty, to live right. Ball was passed into Bruss, went through his legs, and went into Perkins. Perkins put it in the basket.
18-15, again, a three-point North Carolina lead. All kinds of folks waiting to come into the ball game as Tillman stops and pops. He is off right now, and that certainly doesn't help the Rutgers cause.
I'd get the ball to Remley.
Jim Braddock, Sam Perkins.
Sam can hit that shot.
Jordan outraces Battle for the ball, and now they'll go back to Braddock on top of the key.
That zone packed in all the way to the foul line, as deep as it can be. They're playing basically now a 1-2-2, switching it around to a 2-3.
3 minutes, 12 seconds to go in the first half, 18-15.
No. This is the closest thing to a man-for-man zone, if you'll pardon the expression, as you'll find. It's not much more than a switching man-for-man.
Well, Carolina will take what Rutgers gives them. They apparently adopted that philosophy very early when Rutgers came out on the zone defense the first time down the floor for North Carolina. And for the most part, the Tar Heels have taken good shots. Dean Smith says, get it inside, as he retreats back to the North Carolina bench.
That's what Dean Smith says. He says move, and that's what they're not doing.
Perkins runs it down. And there's another turnover. Good pass up front to John Battle, and Rutgers trails by a point.
And when Rutgers gets that situation, they're ready to run. Battle is a quick ball player.
18-17.
Back in that zone defense, it gives you the look of a matchup situation completely.
Jim Braddock will try his hand. Perkins tries to go over the back of Black for the rebound. It goes off Kevin Black, and Carolina will keep it. All sorts of folks coming in. Jimmy Black. Well, we'll run him down for you because a timeout has been called on the floor with 2 minutes and 3 seconds to go in the first half of this one from Madison Square Garden in New York. As you look at that layup by John Battle just a moment ago off the North Carolina turnover that allowed Rutgers to pull to within a point at 18-17. Dean Smith made a number of substitutions. Sam Perkins, James Worthy, Jimmy Black, Michael Jordan. That's the lineup for North Carolina. They go to Worthy on the baseline in heavy traffic. He's fouled by Clarence Tillman.
That's right. Tillman got him on the arm. He came down. While he was in the air, he looked again for someone to pass it to. When he found no one, he came down and went back up.
Well, it has been a steady parade from the Carolina bench to the scorer's table and onto the floor as James Worthy gets set to shoot the free throws, and Matt Daugherty replaces Jeff Barlow. Worthy with 6 points, all from the field, his first venture to the free throw line. In fact, Michael Jordan has been the only Carolina player up to this point to go to the line, and he hit 2 out of 2 earlier.
Got to get some zip in North Carolina if they're going to win this basketball game, because they have no easy opponent.
Carolina has not been, up to this point in the season, a good free throw shooting team, which is something that I'm sure causes grave concern to Dean Smith. That gives you a pretty good indication as Worthy misses both shots. Inside to Perkins. Excellent pass by Jimmy Black. Now Worthy, Daugherty, and Perkins have 16 of North Carolina's 20 points. Carolina leads by 3, and Rutgers turns it over. Off the hands of Tillman to this waiting Sam Perkins.
Best way to beat this defense is beat it down the floor.
Only a minute and 17 seconds on the clock. There's Perkins again.
The thing that got that, Marty, was Daugherty faked the ball on the outside, pulled that zone defense out, and then whipped it back to Perkins.
22-17 Tar Heels. A 5-point advantage is their biggest. Ball will remain to Rutgers. Chris Brust, Jimmy Braddock, onto the floor, replacing James Worthy and Mike Jordan.
Chris Brust, number 24, Jimmy Braddock.
Well, the inbounds pass stolen by Braddock, but he is out of bounds. He almost turned in a sensational play.
Nebelin had no idea that someone wasn't behind him because the pass was so high, and then Braddock almost got it.
Chris Rembley will inbounds. Ron Moses was in the game and very quickly goes back out. Ellerby handles, 58 seconds remaining. 22 North Carolina, 17 Rutgers. With Bones McKinney, Marty Brenneman from Madison Square Garden in New York. It's been a close first 20 minutes of play, I'll tell you that. Inside it goes to Black. He knocked down Jimmy Black. No foul called, and Tillman strips the nets. Clarence Tillman with 5 points. Rutgers down by 3. Carolina will in all likelihood try and play for one shot. Or if they put it up, it's going to be an awfully good one. Daugherty pinned underneath the Tar Heel basket. And he'll go to the line to shoot on the foul charged against Chris Rembley.
Remley didn't believe he did anything wrong. You see the situation right here. Darty's going to have the ball. Watch him go under. He fouled him there. Here's the fake. Now watch it go up. He got him across the shoulder and the arm, the head, somewhere near the nose. Both coaches are having a field day on these referees, and the referees will make it out like they got earplugs.
Carolina's hit but 8 out of 20 shots from the floor, but Rutgers is worse than that, 6 out of 20.
Neither one of them can't buy one. They're talking about shooting 50 and 60%.
5 points for Daugherty, averaging 13 on the year, and an excellent free throw shooter at 80%. 24-19, back up to 5, the Carolina lead. Ellerby up to Remley, inside, ball deflected by Perkins. Braddock off to Black, he drives, puts it up, blocked out of bounds, foul is called.
I think Ellerby got him. Ellerby's raising his hand, I know he's the man got him. That little Black plays a basketball game. Watch the situation. Black's going in, got a pass from Michael, and you watch the situation as he came down on him.
So Jimmy Black will shoot two shots as you look at Brian Ellerby picking up foul number one of the night. We mentioned Cardinal Hayes High School. You look at it. Graphically, as Black bends, shoots, and misses.
I tell you, those fouls are hurting North Carolina, hurting them bad. It's a good thing he had two shots. He's got a chance for another one.
Carolina 4-for-7 from the free line. Jimmy Black, the second Tar Heel player to miss two shots.
Perkins gets a foul on it.
That is only foul number one against Sam Perkins. Tom Young, in his ninth year as head coach at Rutgers, compiling a record of some 170 wins and 72 losses. You see the score. Young, after earlier coaching for 9 years at Catholic U and then going to American University, has been one of the fine coaches in collegiate basketball. Only 12 seconds to go in the half. Tillman with a fadeaway. Rebounded by Perkins. Carolina has to hurry up. Rust will run it down. He slings it up toward the basket. It'll go out of bounds. The clock stops with two seconds.
2 seconds to go. This top first shot. That was foolish basketball. You might as well put skins and shirts and do something like that.
Well, pick up sides and have at it.
That's right. Get in the alley play.
Jimmy Braddock, he will throw it up from long range. Well, the first 20 minutes of basketball is in the books. At the end of the first half of play, the score, the Tar Heels of North Carolina 24, the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers 19, and let's pause for this timeout. Tillman plays to Ellerby, and we're underway. Kevin Black, the jumper by Niederlein.
That's the man.
His jumper puts Rutgers on the board and cuts the Carolina lead to 3 points at 24-21.
That's a 2-3 zone now. Packed deep in there, but they're still matching up because they're having Black to run that baseline when someone's in the corner. It's a matchup.
And there's a blind pass that goes awry, intended for Sam Perkins. Rutgers comes up with a loose basketball and a pass by Michael Jordan, and now they can get to within one, but Carolina forces a turnover. Good play by Worthy. Daugherty up ahead to Jordan. Yeah.
And Niederlein was going to block that one, but Jordan just soared over his head and slammed Duncan.
They slam for Michael Jordan. Carolina leading by 5 again at 26-21. Brian Ellerby throwing it up for one of the rare times tonight. Daugherty plays to Black. Jimmy almost lost it on the dribble.
I think sometimes when Daugherty makes that move, he ought to take that shot.
He's a smart player, Bones.
Yes, he is.
And just as soon as we say it, he delivers a bad pass. Tillman intercepts.
Happens every time.
Kevin Black over Jimmy Black.
He's gotten the last three rebounds, Daugherty has. Man, he could hit Worthy coming down that middle if he'd looked a little quicker.
There's Jordan. Tipped up by Worthy, rebounded by Tillman. Carolina's never had larger than a 5-point lead, which they enjoy right now at 26-21.
I don't think Dean Smith liked that last shot that Mike Jordan took.
They bring the big man Henson out to handle the basketball, and now he rolls down low again with Sam Perkins all over him. Interesting, the comments you hear from a bench when you're sitting as close as we are.
To the North Carolina bench.
Henson turns around and pumps it up off the glass.
Man, that's got to be a
save by Kevin Black. There's James Werther. Michael Jordan almost lost it. Daugherty finally puts it up and in.
I'll tell you one thing. Daugherty's made good selections. He's made good shots. He's done a good job off the board, and he's played good defense.
He has 8 points. Henson from 15. I'll tell you, Rutgers is getting some good shots and simply cannot make them go.
They've had good shots. That's true.
Alley-oop it to Jordan. Worthy double clutches it. Matt Daugherty, there he is again. Perkins hit, no, the shot didn't go, but he was fouled by Kevin Black.
North Carolina's come back with more intensity, Marty, in this second half now. These two or three baskets have been picked up simply because of hustle and desire.
First foul of the evening against Kevin Black, junior from Washington, D.C., an area of the country that Tom Young has had great success recruiting in. Perkins will go for two as Chris Rimley replaces Clarence Tillman on the Rutgers front line. Jeb Barlow has come in for North Carolina. Well, Matt Daugherty, who was all over the place since the outset of the second half, gets a breather with Barlow replacing him, and Carolina continues to have problems from the free throw line.
Made 4-for-8 the first half, and they started off the second half with the same situation.
Perkins has his 9th point. Carolina now possibly starting to open up some daylight. An 8-point lead at 29-21. Ellerby splitting Jordan and Black, but fouled by James Worthy. And that's Worthy's 3rd.
I imagine Dean Smith will get him out of there because he needs him. Needs him bad in the latter stages of the game. If you can get off 6 minutes of clock, he can come back.
3 fouls on Worthy. Rutgers keeps the basketball. Niebuhr. They pretty much dare him to take the long jumper. He elects to give it up to Ellerby and now gets it right back. This could be a very important time down the floor for Rutgers. Trailing by 8 points. Niebuhr, he hits a big one. 29-23. Matt Daugherty at the scorer's table, in all likelihood ready to come on for James Worthy. Perkins drives, shovel shot. No, but a slam, and it will be disallowed, and the Carolina bench erupts.
I don't know if we can see that again or whether we will see it again. Be interesting. You see Sam Perkins, it sort of cat licks it a little bit. Ball gets up on the rim, and you see Perkins as he, the ball was on the rim, and you cannot touch it while it's on the rim.
Bones, they didn't call that. They call a foul on Perkins for going over the top of the back of the Rutgers player with position inside.
Well, in that case, the basket should have been good.
Dean Smith continues to argue as they call the personal foul on Sam Perkins for going over the top as he tried to follow his own missed shot and did with success, but got the foul and the basket was wiped out.
Boy, I couldn't see that.
It remains a 6-point Carolina lead. On the baseline drive, Kevin Black. Jimmy Black takes it away. A good lead pass to Worthy. He shuttles it back to Perkins. Worthy goes down.
That's his 4th foul there.
And that's going to be his 4th personal foul as he decks Brian Ellerby.
There you go. You see his move. You see that he jumps.
That's a defensive play turned in by Jimmy Black at the other end.
Beautiful.
That is 4 personal fouls on Worthy. He is out of the game. And one of the big guns, the big gun in Carolina's attack, their top scorer now on the bench, and Rutgers trying to take advantage of it, and they do.
Real
on the drive by
down.
Kevin Black.
Good move there, Marty. Good bounce pass.
in near the basket.
The Rutgers was down by eight. They've cut the Carolina lead at four, 29-25. We've got 15 and a half to go in the game. Carolina getting a test tonight from the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers University. Jordan to Jimmy Black, almost travel with the ball.
Gave a little walkie step like a duck walk.
Mike Jordan, let's fly. Tip up, Perkins, rebounded by Chris Brust. He brings it out of traffic.
Boy, you got to be tough to be in under that.
Perkins makes his move under heavy defense. That, my friends, was a big Tar Heel basket. 31-25, they lead it.
This is a low-scoring ball game, Marty. I never expected this.
Perkins with a steal, and the ball was deflected into the hands of center court to Kevin Black, and he's been called for over and back. So Carolina will have the basketball when we return. Right now, a timeout on the floor with a score. North Carolina 31, Rutgers 25. We'll pause for this timeout. Floor.
He doesn't usually get upset like that, Marty. You got to believe in the kid.
Michael Jordan tries to penetrate, shut off. Daugherty picks up the ball.
Jordan, not fearful of anything. He'll go into no man's land.
I'll tell you. Jimmy Black. Mike Jordan starts his move. Now let's fly with a bank shot.
He's not a tough freshman basketball player. I don't believe I've ever seen one.
He doesn't play like one, does he, Coach?
No, he plays like about a sophomore.
33-25. We have 14 minutes to go in the ball game, and Rutgers continues to hang tough. Hinson rebounded by Nieberlein. Out of bounds, or is it? Nope. Sam Perkins saves it.
North Carolina.
Jimmy Black
really
looks to Daugherty in the middle, upstairs to Jordan. Tip up and in by Sam Perkins.
What a beautiful move by Perkins after Jordan had missed it. He just rolled it in from over the top.
Carolina has opened it up to a lead of 10 as Rutgers coach Tom Young comes off the bench, signals, and gets a Scarlet Knights timeout. We'll be back at Madison Square Garden right after these messages on the Raycom Sports Network.
Out that Tom Young called for Rutgers because they need to settle down a little bit. This is an important play right here, a little important basket. They need it very much.
That they do. Nieberlein almost threw an errant pass, and Ellerby gets into the land of the Giants, misses a jumper. The little guy gets his own rebound. He flings up a Hail Mary. Rembley misses. Michael Jordan and a whistle.
And you know, so often after you miss two or three easy shots, somebody's going to make a foul.
Michael. And it'll be a Rutgers foul. That is foul number four on Captain Roy Hinson.
You heard Dean Smith tell Michael, and he told him, stay on that backboard.
Now when you've got a 43-44-inch vertical leap like he does, that's a good place to be.
That's at least what he's got.
Jimmy Black calls a play as he brings it over the line for North Carolina. Jordan gets a screen from Daugherty. Brust tried for the tip, and he's going to get a foul for his efforts.
Brust is going to get it.
Followed by Chris Brust.
That is the first of the night on the senior from Babylon, New York. Neither club as yet is in the penalty. That is foul, team foul number four against Carolina. At times, you probably will hear Dean Smith issuing instructions from the Carolina bench as he just did a moment ago. There's Nieberlein. Carolina wanted a walk violation call, but the officials were not having any of it.
He could have carried his suitcase with him that time.
Nieberlein takes it inside in a sea of arms. A shot by Tillman blocked from Perkins. Jimmy Black to the breaking. Daugherty got it.
That's a beautiful play. Jimmy Black deserves all the credit there along with Daugherty. Matt went in after that basket as if he had to have it.
He gave it to him at the right time, didn't he, Bones?
He did. He waited. He looked behind him first. Now watch the situation. The block shot. Now watch Black get it. You see Daugherty going. Daugherty's on the left. Here they come down the court. Black's got the ball. Watch the way he holds on to it. Good pass with the left hand. Matt goes in, rolls it in the basket.
And Daugherty completes a three-point play that sends Carolina's lead out to 13 at 38-25. Well, everything going Carolina's way right now. If they can get Rutgers to start running with them, this could be a most interesting 12 minutes and 40 seconds of basketball as far as that Carolina offense is concerned. Remley throws up an air ball. And Daugherty, as he has been so many times tonight, Johnny on the spot with a rebound.
A bounce pass will get that ball into Perkins if they'll make a good move with the faking the pass into him.
Nieberlein fouling Perkins as both try to jockey for position. The official right there to whistle Chris Nieberlein's third foul.
It's just a matter who gets caught first
or gets caught last. They were both pushing and shoving.
And fouled by Chris Nieberlein. That's his third personal foul.
Oh, it's packed in there, isn't it? They can touch hands. That defense can go hand to hand.
Carolina 38, Rutgers 25. They alley-oop it to Perkins, and the ball got away from Sam.
Sam almost made a good move.
Hey, Rutgers needs a hoop in the worst kind of way. Kevin Black cannot give it to him, and Chris Brush rebounds a missed shot, and Nieberlein gets another one.
That's his fourth, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
They need that young man, too.
Followed by Chris Nieberlein. That's his fourth personal foul.
Here you're going to see it. You see the push off a little bit by Brust, and you see Nieberlein come over the top of him. And Brust swings, and that's a technical foul if you swing hard enough, close enough to a man. And he almost hit me, Jim.
Jimmy Black, Michael Jordan, Chris Brust. Carolina looking to get the good one, and Jimmy Black will throw it up from 17 in and out. Daugherty got a hand on it. Tillman collars it for Rutgers. $11,535 here in the Garden tonight. That has to be a disappointing crowd by anybody's projection. Ellerby throws up a Hail Mary, picked off long by Jordan. Wrap around dribble, and it goes to Black to Daugherty.
Hey, was that beautiful? Beautiful. Michael Jordan's pass to Black, and Black to Daugherty, and Daugherty puts it in the basket.
A wraparound dribble by Mike Jordan got him free. Off to Jimmy Black, to the breaking Matt Daugherty for the field goal, and another Rutgers timeout with 10 minutes and 56 seconds remaining in the game. Carolina is smoking. The Tar Heels lead Rutgers 40-25 as we take a timeout for these messages. I love it. It was the play of the night up to this point, I'll tell you.
I'd say he palmed the ball.
Possibly. The Rutgers, the onus on their back. Here's a steal by Michael Jordan. He can get it.
The young man from Wilmington has turned it off.
42-25. The lead is at 17. Well, Carolina now showing everybody here in the Garden why they are number one in the nation. Let's see if Jordan's going to be called for the personal foul on the missed shot off the baseline. He will be.
Here's the situation. Watch this slam dunk by Michael Jordan. The man 6'4", takes both hands, puts it through the basket. Don't you know Wilmington's proud of him?
Team foul number 6 against the Tar Heels, and Rutgers will inbounds. It was 24-19 at halftime. The field goal attempt misses in tight, and Jimmy Black bear hugs the basketball.
I tell you, Rutgers, they've got to feel like their luck is all bad, because they've had so many opportunities and missed so many easy shots near the basket.
Chris Brush wants to go inside to Sam Perkins. Carolina has really turned it on, two bones, in the absence of James Worthy.
Right. Well, they've gotten some good breaks, fast breaks.
There's Daugherty inside Perkins. And he lost the ball as he started up. Matt Daugherty and Perkins are both appealing to the official that he was fouled.
They said he said it hit the brace behind the basket. If he did that, then it's out of bounds.
Be that as it may, Rutgers gets the ball back.
That's right. Now North Carolina started to move with 17 out of 39. That's a little bit more like it.
17 for 39 for the game. Wow.
Rutgers 10 for 41.
10 for 41. Kevin Black rejected by Sam Perkins. Jimmy Black. Carolina wants a fast break again, but Ellerbe cuts in front of Mike Jordan to steal. And now Chris Remley waiting to run the basketball down. Goes to Black inside. Kevin Black's second field goal.
Now they need to settle it down a little bit now. Work it around. Get him a good shot. Keep that big lead. Rutgers planting back to the foul line again.
Rutgers playing with their top scorer, Clarence Tillman, on the bench. Ball deflected, but picked off by Jordan, left open. 12-point night for Mike Jordan. Carolina leading again by 17 at 44-27. And we've got just under 9 minutes remaining in the game.
North Carolina's going to a zone, 2-3, just stepping on the outside a little bit.
Remley, he hit two bombs in the first half. This one a little bit long. Jordan just hands it off to senior point guard Jimmy Black, and James Worthy running in front of us gets ready to come back in along with Jeb Barlow. Chris Brust almost has it taken away. Dean Smith yelling at him to protect the ball. There's Jordan again. He double clutches it up and in.
Man, you got to be lucky. You got to.
The Michael Jordan Show is on to rave reviews in New York.
What's this situation right here? Here goes Michael Jordan with the ball. He looks for somebody can't. He puts it up and in.
And he is a high scorer right now for North Carolina.
Jim Braddock, number 24, is in for the Tar Heels.
Jimmy Braddock replaces Jordan. 15 points. He goes to the bench with, and 11 of them have come here in the second half.
And 11 big ones at a time. They need them, and most of the time, as you said, it was showtime.
I'm telling you. Ellerbe to midcourt and Kevin Black. John Battle, let's fly.
That was John Battle.
4 points for the Washington, D.C. freshman. 47-29. Carolina leads by 18. Barlow fakes to Braddock, gives to Worthy. Back to Braddock. A bid for the steal took Battle out of the play. There's Matt Doherty. Inside Worthy.
They're going inside now, Butter, but of course that zone's loosening up because they're having to make too many challenges on the outside.
Worthy has scored 8 points, but he's spent considerable time on the bench tonight because of foul trouble. Carolina by 20. Ellerbe tries to get his club back with an 18. Can Worthy above the iron for the rebound, and he's called for traveling. Here comes Clarence Tillman back into the Rutgers lineup.
Clarence Tillman, number 35, is in
for Chris Remley. Tillman, we mentioned earlier tonight, a transfer from the University of Kentucky. He played at West Philadelphia High School, and his frontline teammate, a fellow by the name of Gene Banks.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Good play.
A couple of good ones, I'll tell you.
North Carolina's taking some chances now. Worthy made a desperate move there. Not a desperate move, but he made a move that he wouldn't make ordinarily. North Carolina stays in that 2-3 zone. And it's been very effective.
Well, the clock, of course, an ally of North Carolina, is leading by 20 points. 7 minutes and 7 seconds and running.
And North Carolina's got that zone backed up about like Rutgers had theirs all night.
Rutgers has scored only 10 points here in the second half. The long jumper by Tillman. Nieberlein battles along with Doherty for the rebound. And Matt Doherty is called for his first foul.
Dean Smith walked by here and said they're trying to make it close around here.
Give the people their money's worth. What the heck?
That's right. That's right.
Also number 23, Michael Jordan.
Jimmy Braddock will be lifted in favor of Mike Jordan. Inbounds pass goes deep to John Battle.
I tell you, this little Jimmy Black is about as smart a basketball player out there as you're going to find. He does things that nobody ever notices and you don't get on the stat sheet.
I'll tell you, Rutgers can't afford to fool around too long with a basketball.
No, you play around with it like that and that clock will keep ticking.
Ellerbe from way out. 6 points for Brian Ellerby, 49-31.
Dean doesn't want him to get back in this basketball game, and he's just as intense as he was when the game started.
They go down the lane to Perkins. A high bank, no good. The rebound by Tillman of Rutgers. They break off of Chris Niederlein. They work it in low. The shot rejected by Perkins. The ball goes out of bounds. Rutgers will keep it.
You see Jimmy Black make that move against Ellerby? Just another little second there, and he'd had the ball slapped off his knee, and it would have been North Carolina out of bounds. Good move.
Yeah. Well, Ellerby shouting out instructions. Tillman. John Battle. Battle will try his hand at long range, and here's Sam Perkins.
Perkins will sky you. He must have been a yard above that basket when he took that ball.
Well, the ball slapped out of bounds. Carolina will keep it. And inbounds with 5:38 to go, leading by a score of 49-31.
We're right here by the North Carolina bench, and Dean's been up a few times, but the last time he just turned around and smiled to his assistants. I believe he knows something.
Daugherty looking inside, and a bad pass delivered. Tillman got his hand on it, but could not keep it from going out.
Telegraphed his pass. That's like telling somebody you know it. This is the first time, Marty, I've been in big time. Haven't been on the tube all night.
Well, you have a first occasionally. There's Worthy.
He walked with it.
Call for traveling.
He walked with it, no doubt about it.
Well, a monster slam by James Worthy, wiped off by the traveling violation. 49-31 it remains, 5 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the game as Tom Young of Rutgers calls another timeout. 5 minutes, 17 seconds to be precise here in the Garden of New York. The score, Tar Heels leading Rutgers 49-31, as you can see. And we pause for this.
Okay.
5:10 to go in the game. Carolina very much in command, thank you, leading by 18 at 49-31.
And staying in that zone defense, one of the reasons is because of the fouls. The other reason is it isn't necessary to play a man for man now because they've got a lead that I don't believe Rutgers can catch.
Well, with two little guys in the backcourt and both freshmen, Tom Young getting a look at Brian Ellerby, who he has seen extensively tonight, and John Battle. Tillman has not performed well in this game, and Worthy might have number five of the night. Nope, Sam. Michael Jordan is charged with a personal foul, and that's his fourth.
It's 1-1 on the foul line.
That is There's Rutgers Michael. In the 1-1 situation, so they'll be shooting from the free line with Kevin Black to do it. I'd like to pass along the name of the winner of the sports quiz from the UNC Tulsa game on December 3rd, Mr. Tyrus Tatum of Route 2, Box 358, Stoneville, North Carolina, 27048.
That's a home of Teapot Fry. One of the great baseball players, really. Never made the majors, but he could play.
Teapot Fry. All right, I'll take your word for
Walter
it.
Walter T. Fry. Dean's upset again. Dean Smith has walked down.
Well, they have awarded Kevin Black two shots on the foul, and Carolina's of the opinion that it should have been 1-1. Academic now because he misses them both. It's still 49-31. The two clubs have been stuck on those respective scores for quite a while. Worthy Perkins. Mike Jordan, who's had a great second half. To Matt Daugherty, who has had simply a great game.
You know who I think's played a great basketball game, isn't going to show in the stats?
Jimmy Black.
You're right. You got that quiz. Now you can get one of those little machines.
Boy, I'm starting to think like you now, I'm telling you. Well, Mike Jordan has taken a shot in the nose, apparently, or the eye, as he started up with a shot. He came away without the basketball and started backpedaling as he held his face. And now the official stop play momentarily as Chris Remley comes in for Kevin Black, and they make sure that Mike Jordan is okay.
North Carolina's ball out of bounds, I believe, because that's been the first time. You see the situation right here. You see Michael go up in the air, and it looked to me like that he was stripped.
Darius Griffin, a 6'1 senior from Lakewood, New Jersey, gets his first game action of the night, replacing Brian Ellerby. Griffin, a former football player at Rutgers.
He was supposed to play a whole lot.
Down the lane, Jimmy Black kicks it back to Daugherty. Shot is batted away by Griffin, who goes down on the seat of his pants, and Carolina will retain possession.
He was right for not liking it.
Carolina has been up by as many as 20. Right now, their lead is at 18. Inside Black.
Jimmy deserved that. He's played so well tonight in so many ways.
His first points, Bones.
Huh?
His first points of the game.
Yeah, but he's played so well.
51-31. Back up in front by 20. Nieberlein tries to muscle it up and in. Can't get it to go. Picked off by Remley. Stripped to the ball. Got it back. Stripped again. A loose ball picked up by Darius Griffin of the Scarlet Knights. Fadeaway jumper by Remley.
Oh, somebody
Tillman
slapped it.
Banks. Sam Perkins clears. Jimmy Black has Matt Daugherty and Perkins. A blind pass to the breaking Perkins. He'll go to the line.
Yep, it's on Tillman.
Eldon Miller, the head coach of the Ohio State Buckeyes, sitting directly across the way from us watching this one. His ball club reigned victorious over Princeton 59-55 in the opening game of this Madison Square Garden doubleheader. Ron Moses for Clarence Tillman, the Carolina huddle, and now Perkins will shoot him.
1-1 on the line, and the shooter is Sam Perkins.
Perkins, 1-for-2 from the free throw line, has scored 13 points.
Chris Bruss, number 45.
Chris Bruss, on for James Worthy.
James Worthy.
Worthy leaves with 8 points.
That's low, but that's a low score, 52 points.
And now Buzz Peterson will get set to come on for Carolina. Peterson on for the first time tonight, the 6'3 freshman from Asheville, North Carolina, replacing Mike Jordan. Freshman for freshman. Dean Smith starting now to unload his bench with under 3.5 minutes to go in the game and leading by 22, 53-31.
A battle is battling his way out of there, isn't it?
Battle Griffin, Remley, Nieberlein looks for help and finds it in battle as he springs from long range. It went all the way in and
they've
came all the way out.
They've had some tough luck. You have to admit, Rutgers has had some tough luck all night. Well, second half anyway.
I'll tell you, they hung with Carolina for quite a while. There's Peterson on the end line, played very well in his last outing, and makes a nifty pass to Daugherty.
Oh, that's a beautiful pass by Peterson. Made a good pass to Daugherty.
15-point night for Matt Daugherty. 55-31, Carolina's lead 24, the biggest. Now Lynn Robinson about to come onto the floor as Nieberlein goes to the hole and foul on the drive.
Here comes a little Linwood Robinson from Goldsboro.
Jimmy Black leaves.
Well,
the starters, Worthy, Black, and Jordan have all checked out, and Warren Martin, the 7-footer from Axton, Virginia, is on now for Sam Perkins. Perkins leaves with 15. Carolina with three players showing 15 points apiece, Mike Jordan, Sam Perkins, and Matt Daugherty. Here comes Cecil Exum. Sophomore from Dudley, North Carolina, for Matt Daugherty. So all the starters have been lifted now.
Now he's played a fine basketball game.
That
Matt Daugherty has probably played the best ball game of anybody, but the man that broke it open was Michael Jordan, and he did it with the help of Jimmy Black.
Well, the free throw misses, and Warren Martin gets the rebound. He plays it off to Linwood Robinson. Robinson trying to elude the defender, off to Cecil Exum. Exum pinned to the baseline, puts up the jumper, and is fouled by Chris Remley. Now John Brownlee will come on for Chris Bruss. And with the coming of Brownlee, everybody has now seen action with the exception of sophomore Timo Mäkinen. Exum will shoot a couple of shots with 2 minutes and 5 seconds remaining.
Somebody told me they went after Brownlee, and when they got out there, they found out that Brownlee's daddy had room with Dean Smith.
And they were at Kansas. That's right.
I know, that's true. Exum misses them both. Remley with a rebound. Battle goes to the baseline, and the jumper by Griffin. Follow shot by Remley. Loose ball picked up by Lynn Robinson. Robinson is knocked down, and no whistle on the play.
It was tripped.
Battle with a long shovel shot down the lane, and what have we got here? We're going to put Battle on the line.
Followed by John Brownlee.
Brownlee picks up the personal foul, and Battle will have one-on-one coming.
John Battle on the line.
Battle, who has seen little playing time so far this season, has gotten quite a bit tonight. He scored 5 points.
Pretty well while he's been in there.
So Carolina, who held South Florida to only 39 points last Saturday night, in all likelihood is going to hold Rutgers to even less.
Well, they can flat play some defense, I'll tell you.
Peterson, a good shooter. That one a little bit long, however, and a Carolina foul will go against Cecil Exum. Round of their own tip-off tournament or invitational tournament at Rupp Arena in Lexington. They play Seton Hall tonight. They win that game and they will be undefeated when they take on Carolina next Saturday. Exum to Brownlee. Back to Exum. He fakes a baseline jumper, goes to John Brownlee, puts it up, shot deflected, picked up by Buzz Peterson. Minute 17 to go. Exum fires and hit. Good pass by Peterson as he and Exum slap hands. Cecil gets a field goal and will go to the free line.
A lot of times you see a situation like that, that the man would say, what's this situation? See Exum go up in the air and take the shot, but you saw the pass in there by Peterson. Many times a young man like Peterson just getting in the ball game would take the shot himself, but not Buzz Peterson. Passed off beautifully, and Cecil Exum made the basket. 50, now he's at the foul line.
57-32. It will indeed be interesting to find out the comments of one Tom Young when this one is over. Remley kicks it off to Darius Griffin. Battle skying over Mackinnon, who just came in for Carolina. Dean Smith has completely emptied his bench now. Nieberlein drives to reflect it out of bounds by Warren Martin.
Mackinnon.
And a Carolina foul against Mackinnon.
Followed by Tim McConnell.
This is the first ball game he's been in. I'm not sure of that.
I got to believe he played against South Florida.
Yeah, he probably did. I didn't see that ball game. Okay. I've been so wrong about who was the only one that freshmen that ever started for Dean Smith. I even said Charlie Scott, didn't he? You were not eligible as a freshman.
That's right. You adequately surrounded it.
Oh, yeah, you see, if you just talk long enough, you can confuse people.
8 points for Nieberlein. He hits them both, 57-34, 55, 54, 53 seconds to go. Robinson is fouled by Battle.
You know, I used to. We get a situation like this and somebody had me beat, and I got last time out I had, I'd tell them, look, fellas, don't foul nobody.
On the line is Lynn Robinson.
Old iron.
Remley has it smacked away from him, but picked up by Ron Moses. The bomb by Darius Griffin. Timo Mackinnon kept it alive, but Rutgers retains possession. Battle jump up. John Battle with a nice move in heavy traffic.
Gonna pass it off.
Carolina 57, Rutgers 36, out of bounds, Carolina ball, 31 seconds to go.
The late seconds of a ball game like this, you got to draw blood to get a foul shot.
The ball goes to Exum and now back to Robinson. I'll tell you, this young man exhibits a lot of the same traits and tendencies as one Phil Ford. Mackinnon with a tie-up.
Now it'll go out of bounds,
and it should be Carolina's ball.
I believe it'll be Rutgers.
I'm betting Carolina.
Okay, I'll bet Rutgers. They had one over there a minute ago. They made a mistake.
Robinson double-teamed by Griffin in Battle. Plays to Exum. 12 seconds to go. Robinson on the drive. Shovel shot by Lynn Robinson. 59-36. Griffin, he takes it inside, gives to Remley, and that's it.
That's it.
Carolina, absolutely. absolutely rolls in the second half to win it in a cakewalk over Rutgers, a final score of 59-36. We'll be right back in New York City after these messages.